King of them all. As I take you back to that fateful night, beware. This is no ordinary story. Open your minds. Expect the unexpected. There are greater things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt of in your philosophy. How well Enid Blyton summed it all up. Well, to begin the beginning, I remember cycling towards a house at night and reflecting that life in the force is never dull. But little did I think.
All right, Sergeant.
I'm telling you, Sergeant, this is the strangest case I have ever seen. You're going to need somebody really good on this one.
Don't worry, Jack. I've got the greatest detective in the world.
Oh, good. So it won't be that trapped rope then. Oh. Do you have a food? Do you want a sec? I need to get a mugshot. So, who have we got in?
You'll find out soon enough.
Oh, big secret, eh? Very well. Maigret.
No.
Hercule Poirot.
You're getting warmer.
French.
English.
Miss Marple.
Wrong sex.
Not Sherlock Holmes. That's right.
What? Not Sherlock Holmes. You've come right soon enough. This could be him. This door locked.
No, it shouldn't be.
I can't get it open.
Great. So it is you. What did you expect? Danger mouth? I'm telling you, this is the strangest and weirdest case.
Look, I'd like to come prepared. Now, how's it going?
Well, this is the strangest case that I've ever seen.
Managed to get any prints?
Well, only this one, but I don't really like the way it...
Constable, isn't it?
Hello, actually, Sergeant.
Oh, Sergeant. Get over here.
Sergeant!
I want you to give me the lowdown.
Very well, sir. It was about to go on, sir. But, I think we found the body.
Any distinguishing feature?
Yes, sir. He was dead.
I see. So, this is where the body fell.
Yes, sir.
Notice anything strange about the way the body has fallen?
I wonder if you notice, sir.
What, sir? See how the arm is twisted inwards? That suggests
But when the body fell, the arm was twisted inwards.
Right, sir.
You know, I've seen some things in my time, but this takes the biscuit. I'd like to see the forensic boys.
Oh, yes, sir, of course, sir. Yes. Here they are, sir. There you are.
Oh, yes.
David 7 and Cleveland 5.
Who's that in the background, the one with the moustache?
Well, that's him there, sir. No, the wife's in the front, the one with the full beard, sir.
Don't touch that!
Why not?
Like to be possible.
Well, I hope not, it's my lunch.
Oh, I see. Well, has anything else been touched?
No, the room is exactly how it was.
Ah, then the sergeant's standing there. He must have seen all that happened.
Well, I'm still gone, sir. I arrived a bit too late.
Oh. Here. Are there any living relatives?
Only one, sir. But he's dead. There is a butler, sir. Been with him for years.
Catch him in.
Very well, sir.
I'm afraid you're no witnesses to what happened.
You're wrong again, Jack. There was one.
Who?
A murderer himself.
Well, that doesn't count, does it?
On the contrary, we have to find him because then we will know who did it.
The butler, sir.
What's your name, young man?
He's 84, sir.
But what's your name? Good, that can save time. Now, what's your name?
Short, Mr. Short.
Ah, but I didn't say so in the first place. Right, Mr. Short, you're the butler.
I know I am.
Right. Now that the professor has gone, you're not alone here.
Oh, no, sir. You see, I got my pussy to keep me warm.
Humor him, Sergeant. Nice pussy.
Yes, pussy. Inspector, what are you doing down there? My cat is in the garden.
So you're not alone here. Now tell us where you were last evening.
I don't think that's any of your business.
Sergeant, I didn't see that.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I'll do it again.
Sergeant, I got it that time.
Sir. Sorry, sir.
Ah.
I know, sir, but I didn't like the way he was addressing you, sir.
Sergeant!
I didn't hear the word you said, sir.
I said the old git was lying. Now get him back to his quarters, but don't I get him here.
Very good, sir. Excuse me, sir.
My sergeant, I heard him the first time.
Very well. I think we're just about done here.
Tell you what. I'll see you back in the yard. I told you not to wait up.
No drink. I know we've had our differences in the past, but... Really, I wish you well on this one. Let's shake.
I can promise you that within the next 5 minutes, whenever
You're least expecting it, I shall get you.
Now, sir.
Now, gentlemen, it's rather silly. We should be working together, not fighting each other. I promise that I will not get you in trouble.
Really?
Yes, I won't. Scout of
them. Right, sir.
Why don't you go down there, sir?
Sir, can I go to...
Almost got you, that's why. That's why.
What about scout order, sir?
Well, I rather thought Baby Powell was a bit of a prat.
I'll have no surgeon, sir.
Sergeant! Sergeant! Go and find your own bit of wall! Outside.
Right, sir.
Really big.
within the next few hours at least.
Look, someone may come.
No one's likely to come yet.
You don't know me, Miss Duck.
Oh, all right, Sergeant. Any luck?
Not as much as you, we look richer.
So, you really are a detective?
Yes, what do you think I was?
Oh, I'm sorry, I couldn't be sure. Look, I'm not a newspaper reporter at all, and my name's not Duck. It's Williams, Alison Williams.
Williams? Alison Williams?
No, just Alison Williams.
And what are you doing here?
I'm a friend of the professor's daughter.
Oh, the professor has a daughter?
Yes, but now he's dead and she's disappeared. Look, Inspector, Professor, 2 days ago, I received this letter from Maggie.
Who's Maggie?
The professor's daughter.
Professor has a daughter?
Oh, this is terrible.
What is it?
It's an electricity bill, sir.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. This letter from Maggie.
Who's Maggie?
The professor's daughter.
The professor has a daughter.
I didn't say intention.
Read it out, Sergeant.
Oh, sir. Dear Alison, exciting news. My father has finally found what he has been looking for. He intends to try the experiment tonight, and I'm to be
That's guinea pig, Sergeant. It's a two-syllable word. We'll work on those next.
Thank you, sir. And I'm to be the guinea pig. My father wants to come too, but I don't think he's strong enough to make it. Wish me luck. Love, Maggie, the professor's daughter.
Professor's daughter?
What experiment is she talking about, miss?
At first I thought it was all eccentric nonsense, but I was sworn to secrecy. You see, Inspector, Professor Wilberforce was working on a device which he hoped would one day give human beings total freedom of travel, not only through space, but through the fifth dimension.
You mean?
Yes. He was building a time machine.
So that means he'll be transported to another world.
Not necessarily, Sergeant. The experiment would have failed if the professor killed himself
and the daughter ran away.
Oh, she wouldn't do that. Believe me, Inspector. She's out there somewhere.
Well, don't worry.
We will find her.
Oh, the fuck?
We will find her, Sergeant.
It's getting dark. I think you should go to bed.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Not you, Sergeant. We are going to stay here and stay overnight in this room and look for the time machine in the morning.
Oh, Drake, you're the bravest man I've ever met.
You really should get out a bit more, miss.
Can you smell something?
No.
Oh, well, I'm going to go in. Good night.
You did that on purpose, didn't you?
Sir?
Don't give me that innocent look. You know I can smell under your sight of the dentist at 50 yards. You did that on purpose. Oh, you're so disgusting!
Who was that at the blower, sir?
It was Jack.
They've suddenly completed a post-mortem on Professor Willywarmer.
What?
It's been confirmed, there's no doubt about it. He's dead.
You mark my words, sir. This is murder, pure and simple. I think this old time machine is just a load of old nonsense, sir.
You seem to have got a theory, Sergeant.
Well, actually, I have, sir, yes.
Oh, let's hear it. I bet this is going to be a back.
Well, sir, I believe the professor had a row with his daughter. She killed him, and then she covered him with glue and stuck him up there until she committed suicide, sir, and then she scarfed.
That's a real award winner.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Do you think you can muster up enough brain power to get those little legs of yours moving?
Yes, sir.
Then go and see if you can find some blankets and bring them in here. So we're staying here tonight until the morning.
Right, sir. Sir, I've got it. Perhaps this house is haunted.
You don't believe in time machines, but you believe in haunted houses.
Well, just a thought, sir.
There's no such thing as ghosts, Sergeant, but there is such thing as silence. Now, go.
Right, sir.
Out there, there's a sweet, innocent child who's really
relying on us, needs us, and she's alone. We hold the key to her freedom. And this is one of the greatest discoveries of the century. And all you're concerned with is the contents of your nostril.
Good story, sir.
Right, Sergeant.
Good, sir.
Good luck, Trey.
Wish me luck.
I just did.
Oh, yes. Right, Sergeant.
Right, sir. Ready, sir.
Right.
Right.
do. Who are you?
My name is It Mackey.
Gary Mackey.
What do you want with us?
You are our guests.
What's the square root of 5,144?
72.
And the capital of Albania?
Tiny.
They're pretty good, you know, Sergeant. Who was the first? I've started, so I'll finish.
Excuse me, Mr. Drake.
How did they know my name?
Yellow. Yes, High Priestess. Yes, everything is going to plan. There is something you must know, though. There are two Earthlings. Excuse me.
Right, Mr. Drake. I bet you have 1,000 questions.
Yes, I have. I've forgotten which ones I want to ask.
You are currently circling about 1,000,000 miles from Earth, Mr. Drake.
Well, what year is this?
According to our calculations on Earth, the year is 2950. Your planet is very young.
2950? My God, it'll be just 1,000 years.
Oh, I hope we're indoors didn't wake up.
Now, look out!
A simple force, Mr. Drake. I'm afraid we must keep you here for a while.
Well, what do you want us for?
We are scientists, Mr. Drake. We are interested in all forms of intelligent life.
All right, Sergeant, you can go.
We have given you both a second brain scan.
Brain scan.
What?
Yes, Mr. Drake. That is how I know your name. I know every little detail of your life. Your childhood. What you have for breakfast. Your fetish about shoes.
All right, I get the picture.
But the little one, the one with the head like a metallic mammary gland.
Tint.
Eat.
He has the ability to block the brain scanner.
Brain scanner. Okay, no reason.
Yes, I think I can explain that.
So we must find another way.
Yes.
What way?
Simple. We will cut off the top of his head and put in probe.
It's all right, Sergeant. We've got him fooled. He thinks the helmet is part of your head.
But it is, sir.
Dear Mrs. Gentleman, I'm afraid you must excuse us. Until we return, you may enjoy the hospitality of the ship. If you need anything, you must clap 3 times.
3 times.
Well, what kind of substance can possibly withstand your head?
Oh, sir. Sir. I need to relieve myself.
Don't me.
But I have to go, sir. I'm desperate, sir.
But go in the corner. No, don't do that. You might sort of short-circuit something and blow a fuse and blow us all up. Use your helmet.
Idea. You know when they said to clap your hands 3 times and they'll come?
Yes, sir.
Hey, someone's coming. Quick, the helmet. Back on.
Sir.
Look, they think the helmet's off their head. If you don't see the head, Sergeant, do it! Steady on, Sergeant.
I'm Loomy. Whatever you desire, I can give it to you.
But will you get us out of this force field?
I'm sorry, I cannot do that.
Well, I thought not.
I'm sorry.
That's all right.
I'm sorry.
That's all right.
I'm sorry.
Oh, shut up.
I apologize for that. There is a bug in my software which sometimes causes me to repeat myself. The fault will be corrected in Mark 3 Android.
No,
I see.
I apologize for that. There is a bug in my software that modifies what we need. Exit, confirm, reset, enter. Hello, I'm...
Sergeant, you've broken her now.
Oh, you get on my nerves, sir, to be in the summer, you're indoors.
That's just an amazing device. So lifelike.
Come, have a look around the back, see if there are any buttons.
Oh, yes, sir. There's something, it says something, sir. The desk's price promise, sir.
Is that all?
Batteries not included. Oh, there's a little button here, sir.
Well, press it.
Hello, I am Looney. What is your desire?
The sergeant wants to go to the toilet.
But I've been, sir.
Sergeant! It's all right, it's part of my plan. Yes, the toilet.
Please try that word.
Oh, lavatory, little boys' room, the loo, waste disposal units.
Of course, you, sir.
Sergeant, I don't think this android is programmed for 20th century slang.
Ah, the Kazi. Follow me, please.
Sergeant, you've cracked it.
Thank you, sir.
Look, we've got to find a way out of here. I knew you'd have to go to bed by now. What's all this stuff?
This is beyond me. Beyond me.
That was your IQ in seconds.
It's well beyond me, sir.
There's another abacus beyond you, Sergeant.
What's we do, sir?
Now, don't touch that. You can't. Two knots are north, anyway.
Who, sir?
Telepathy. Enhancement.
Sir, I know it is, sir. I know it is, Sergeant. I know it is, sir. I do you say that, sir.
I know. It's hard to just get it off, but it's driving me mad.
Sir, it took off. I expect you to say that.
You know, I've been through some things in my time, Sergeant. The first time I've been a prisoner in a Zircon space cruiser.
Oh, me too, sir.
Yes, but I'm still the world's greatest detective. And there is a way out.
Is there?
If you know where to look. Now, these all-powerful aliens must have an Achilles heel.
What, sir?
A weak spot, Sergeant. You see, all strong persons have a weak spot, like the mighty Achilles.
And what was his weak spot, sir?
His heel, Sergeant.
Well, what a coincidence.
Yes, we all know where your weak spot is, don't we? That bit of gruel between your ears, that's laughingly called a brain. Now, we have to find out their weak spot. And I think I may have done it. But if I'm not mistaken, this bag is full of drugs. Maybe these all-powerful beings with their clever machines are nothing more than a load of junkies. You know what junkies are, don't you, Sergeant?
Oh, yes, sir. Chinese boats.
Yes, so these smug superintelligent beings are just a load of Chinese boats. Oh, let's see if I'm right. LSD.
Those are... I think you'll find it's cocaine, sir.
No, it's LSD.
No, sir. No. Let me have a look here, sir.
Hey, give that to me.
No, sir. It's mine. I must insist.
Look.
Do I remember once, sir, that this has got my marker there, but somebody used somebody else's spoon and caught a very nasty germ, sir. You know what happened?
We're on a Zircon space cruiser, millions of miles from us, and I didn't bring a spoon for you, and I don't know what happened, so what happened?
Well, all his brain went separate, and his brain removed, sir.
Admit it. That man was you, wasn't it?
No, sir.
Oh. Definitely LSD.
No, cocoon, sir.
Yes.
No, cocoon, sir.
No.
Oh, sir, look.
Down the hill.
There's an orange gorilla on your head, sir.
What?
It's orange gorilla in your head.
Who cares?
Oh, Sergeant. Oh, sir. Look. Drugs screw you up.
You're right, sir. And remember that at home, won't you, kids? Drugs screw you up.
Someone's coming. Oh!
So, you've discovered our little secret, have you, Drake? I'm afraid that means the end of the world.
Quick, Sergeant, use the universal language of the truncheon.
Right, sir.
It seems to be working. Everything's gone all blurred.
Is that again, sir?
Yeah.
Look.
Oh!
It seems like that.
I
to fall off.
I think they've had an assault.
It looks like some sort of protective device. Prepare again!
Yes, sir.
Now, Mr. Drake, you've become a nuisance. No. I'm afraid I'm going to have to make your
assistant.
Your friend who once reproved his mind.
Well, at least I have the pleasure of knowing that the drugs will kill you all.
Kill us? I'm afraid you're mistaken, Mr. Drake.
Admit it, nothing but an old Chinese boat.
Chinese boats? This expression is not familiar to me, Mr. Drake, but I will explain. We are quite used to the convention of explaining the plot to the hero. We have seen many of our old films, Mr. Drake.
Then you know that the hero always manages to escape in the end.
Not this time, Drake. After all, where will you go? Now, you will recognize this, of course.
Yes, it's a plastic bag.
Do you recognize that content?
Yes, LSD.
Cocaine.
Heroin, gentlemen! This ship is carrying 12 million tons of it. In precisely 30 minutes, we will deposit the entire load over the Earth's surface, all in neat little bags marked Eat Me.
So that means within a few short weeks.
Correct. The entire world will be at our mercy.
But you can't do that. You can't destroy all the people.
They will be destroying themselves, Mr. Drake. Ready, Eve.
Good. Proceed.
Leave him alone.
Silence!
Still nothing, sir.
More power.
Still no reading.
But that's impossible. Surely the Earthling has a brain.
There's something you should know about British police.
You'll have to alter it a couple of degrees to make it correct.
Right.
Capatito!
Yes, sir.
Sergeant, is that you?
Yes, sir. Everything's tickety-boo. I wouldn't do that if I were you.
What?
What you were just about to do.
Oh, that. Right. Don't worry, sir. According to this, his brain will reject the alien information and he will become even more stupid than before.
Oh, that's not possible.
Good. Then we will wait for the effect to wear off. Come, we must inform the High Priestess.
The High Priestess, yes.
Sergeant, get me out of this force field. Sergeant, did you hear what I said?
I heard you, sir. But you remember all the times you ridiculed me and...
Oh, hold it there, Sergeant. Don't you get cocky with me. Remember what they said, that the effects will wear off and you'll be even more stupid than before. Oh, is that possible, a Darwinian link in uniform? Look, get me out of here!
Very well, sir.
Oh!
Mind your order.
Oh! Right. Now, let's put this super intelligence of yours to work. Go and find the android and reprogram her so that she can come and help us.
Oh, that should be a doddle, sir.
Yes, well, do it before the effect wears off.
Right, sir.
Oh, and Sergeant.
Yes, sir.
At the buttons and at the back. There'll plenty of time to play with the rest later.
Very well, sir.
I am a high priestess of the Zircon people.
Oh, do I know you?
I would have thought that was highly unlikely, wouldn't you?
Well, your face looks familiar.
Yes, you're right, it does. Anything wrong?
No, I was just exercising with my arm, but it's okay now, it's much better. If you've anything to discuss with me, you better hurry up because I'm rather busy.
Well, as I said, I'm a high priestess of the Zircon people.
And you're in charge?
That's right, yes.
Mm, how strange. That's ridiculous, a woman in charge of a nation.
And my name is Nia!
I had an answer for that once. You're looking for anything in particular?
Oh, forgive me, it's become a habit of mine.
Oh, yes, but are you sure that we haven't spent some time before?
Well, no, I wouldn't have thought so.
And your face looks so familiar. Are you any relation to Alison Duck? Or otherwise known as Alison Williams?
Well, she was my grandmother.
Oh, I see. But that's impossible. How could that be?
Well, you see, you've got a lot to learn about the complexities of time travel, Rick. Alison Williams came here some thousand years ago in a primitive time machine. The people welcomed her as a goddess from heaven, and so they made her a high priestess, and our family have ruled this planet ever since. She was searching for a man called Drake, but she never seemed to find him.
If that was a thousand years ago, how could she be your grandmother?
Oh, well, you've got a lot to learn about the circumstances as well. You see, it's not unusual for us to live for 500 years. Our planet is a completely sterile environment. We have domes, and there are no germs, nothing at all. But unfortunately, acid rain is eroding them, and so the planet is crumbling away, and soon we will all die.
No, it's very rude to stare, you know, like that, where I come from.
Oh, well, forgive me. You have to understand something. You see, many years ago, we Zirconians perfected a method of artificial insemination, since which time there has been no contact, and all sexual organs have shriveled up. You grow to 2.5 inches, is that true?
No, mine's been more like 9.
I've waited for this moment. Tell me, Drake, do you find me excited?
What?
I said, do you find me exciting?
Now look, High Priestess. Look, this isn't right.
Why, I'm not.
Well, only yesterday I was making love to your granny.
How do you like old women?
Oh, well, a lot.
Well, I'm 192 years of age, well into middle age.
Oh, well, you know what they say, life begins at 190.
Oh, Drake, how I've waited for you.
She wants.
does she want, sir?
Oh, just a thing.
Well, what sort of thing, sir?
Just a thing.
A thing?
Well, a little thing, a medium-sized thing.
No, a large thing.
Well, why don't you just give her this thing so we can get out of here?
It's not as easy as that, Sergeant.
Why, sir?
Cause, sir.
I didn't hear a word you said there.
Sergeant, I said she wants my willy.
Oh. Well, you can't really give her that, can you, sir?
Exactly.
Oh, no. How the man is it, sir?
But you could.
What?
Come on, Sergeant, you never use it anyway.
I used it last Christmas, sir.
Sergeant, your willy is our ticket out of here. Now, come on, hand it over. That's an order.
No, sir, no. Oh, sir, I can't.
What's going on?
Hi, priestess. I was just getting a present ready for you. This is my colleague, Sergeant Flog. This is the High Priestess.
You just called me Warthog Face. Never mind. Now, what about this present?
Come on, Sergeant. Let the young lady see what you've got wrapped up for her.
I think you better stand back a bit, miss.
I'm sorry, High Priestess. I thought he was reaching for a weapon.
Not a bad guess.
Yes, these aliens are dangerous. They have discovered our plans and must be destroyed.
Now look here, Mr. Shriveled Willy.
How dare you? My name is Ink.
That's a Zirconian Paul Shriveled Willy.
Look, all we need to do is for the sergeant and I to go home.
Preferably in one piece.
They know too much, I'm afraid.
Oh, don't forget, we've got something you want.
My priestess, there will be plenty more men on Earth. We must not jeopardize our plan.
Destroy them!
It's all over, Sergeant.
No, Sergeant, I'm too young to go.
Don't worry. Look, do what you've got to do. What are you using anyway? Death ray?
We are not barbarians, Mr. Drake. No. We use the quickest and cleanest method we know. We will throw water in your face!
Chin up, Sergeant. Look, you weren't expecting to reach the 30th century anyway, were you?
Prepare water!
All right, sir. Can I say, it's a pleasure to serve you, sir.
Of course you can.
It's a pleasure to serve you, sir.
Oh, thank you, Sergeant. Come on, let's show them that we're British.
Right you are, sir.
Okay, we are ready.
It is done!
Now entering Vector 5. Vector 5.
We are getting close! We must prepare for the drop!
Prepare!
Prepare!
That's it! Sergeant, pretend to be alive again now.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Well, that's it. Their kill is heat. It's water. They thought the water would kill us, so that can only mean one thing.
They're thick.
I wouldn't like to argue with an expert, Sergeant, but no, don't you see? Water is deadly for them, so they assumed that it was equally deadly for us. Right, now all we have to do is to get this water, and then... throw it in the face.
What?
No! It's too cool! The alien's face. Well, when I say ready... you got it?
Got it, sir.
Good. Right, we'll do it properly this time. Yeah. When we say go, shh. Let's wait for something to come. Oh, shit. Oh.
Drake.
How did you get here?
Well, I tried to follow in the time machine, but I ended up on a strange planet called Zircon in the year 2000. Luckily, I made some friends who transported me back to Earth. Unfortunately, I ended up in the year 4000. But the history book said you'd once been on a Zircon spaceship in the year 2950. So I transported back and here I am.
That's the simplest explanation I've ever heard.
So we made it the history books.
Yes, you almost managed to save Earth from takeover by the Zirconians.
Almost? Oh, so we failed.
Well, this is where this time travel stuff starts getting complicated. You see, I wasn't supposed to come here. According to historical sources, I stayed on Zircon, married and had children.
But I knew your granddaughter.
Really? How is she?
She's doing very well for herself. In fact, she's 190 years old, and she's the one who planned this invasion of Earth.
Precisely. So what if I decide not to go back to Zircon?
Then you won't marry.
And I won't have children.
Then Hypnus won't exist.
That's right.
And then the planned invasion of Earth will never take
place. So all we have to do is to return to Earth at precisely the time that we left.
Yeah, I forget that it ever happened.
Because it won't.
Yeah, oh, that's brilliant. Oh, brilliant.
Brilliant.
You don't get it, do you, Sergeant?
No, sir.
Never mind, it would even people with a brain would find the problem. Look, bone up on this.
Is it, sir?
My pocket Einstein, I always carry it around with me. Now then, how are we going to get out of here?
Well, I'm a bit of an expert now. All you have to do is to set this dial to the precise time of the day.
No, why don't you do it for the day before?
Why?
Then we can prevent the professor from killing himself.
Oh, Drake, you're a genius.
No, it won't work.
Why not?
Well, if we set it for the day before, that means the professor doesn't die and we won't find the time machine.
Oh, then we won't be called in to investigate. So we won't be called in to investigate and we'll find the time machine, then go back and warn him.
So he won't die?
Yes, but then we won't be called in to investigate.
So he'll die?
Yes. Oh, back at him. He was old enough to die anyway. No. Short ass. And goodbye, Miss Duck.
Oh, I'm sure that we shall be meeting again sometime in the future.
I'll be waiting for you, Drake, even if it's 1,000 years from now.
Sergeant. Oh, Sergeant. You know, I think I really shall... I miss you most of all.
Oh, really, sir?
No.
But, sir, wait. You forgot me a little book. Sir.
Give them all.